Hello and welcome to Dazatron's Diorama Llama. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to make a molten lava base for your transformer figures. So this idea came from fellow YouTuber X in Ferris, who's also part of the Robot Recruits Collectors Club. And I'd encourage you to go to robotrecruits.co.uk and check that out, and also to check out X in Ferris's YouTube page, and I'll put links in the description and the comments below. So for this video, I'm going to advise, if you like, to use some of the scraps really, and that's what I've used. And it's, I always like creating videos where I'm reusing materials and not wasting materials. So ideally you might have a few bits left over from previous diorama bases that you may have made if you've been watching my channel for a while. If not, of course, you can make a fresh base, if you like, from a new piece of styrofoam. So it's completely up to you. So I've taken this kind of offcut here, which has got a bit of a slant to it. And I just thought that kind of helped create a little bit of drama. And also, it would give a better impression of this kind of molten lava kind of pouring out as he kind of goes down his rocks. So I thought the slanted base would work really well. And as I'm showing you here, this is another offcut that I've used to create this kind of volcanic rock. And I'll show you how to do that in a bit more detail a bit later. So again, as I've said in many videos before, keep all of your offcuts. They will come in handy for future makes. So you'll need for this video, yeah, a knife and a pen. And for the first time, I'm also going to show you how to use one of these wire brushes. This is a free pack that I picked up for a couple of pounds just from a local DIY shop. This is a nylon brush, which you won't need, but you can also get a, I think it's a bronze and a steel brush, and they are quite useful for this video and this task. So yeah. So pick up yourself a wire brush, really cheap, because it will come in handy a bit later on. So to begin, we just need to get an idea of where our figure will be placed. So I'm using Kingdom Primal here as my kind of despot today. And I'm using him really just to get an idea where the feet would fall. And you, of course, you can do this with any figure you like. I think that's really important, just to have something at hand, just to give you, as I said, an idea of where the feet would rest, so you know where to cut away and where to kind of leave really. So these two kind of arches at the top here essentially are going to be where my character would stand. And then I'm just going to add some other platforms, if you like, where the rocks would kind of stick up out of the lava, just to create more interest really. So you can see I'm just marking that out. Of course, you can change this as you go along. And so I wanted some smaller pieces near the bottom. So again, that kind of slanted part right at the corner of the base would be where the molten lava is kind of seeping out. That's the idea. So you will ideally need a electric foam cutter. Again, there's other videos on my channel showing you how to use these. The regular blade I use is this wire blade here, but you do get these kind of rods with the cutter. They come with it, and they are particularly useful for this piece. There will be other ways you can do this. You certainly could use a knife, you could use a glue gun to create the texture for the lava, but I'm really wanting to show you how to use styrofoam in lots of different ways. So you can see here I've got an offcut. This isn't my main base here, this is just another piece. I've just marked out a couple of lines, and I'm just testing this rod just to see how well it works, or if it works at all. And I just think that's a really good idea before working on your main base. So just take a piece that you don't need really. So just make a slow kind of mark, and you can see it's cutting into the styrofoam really easily. If you have got thinner parts, just be careful that you don't go all the way through. And then here I'm just marking out some lines that just kind of give a bit of a shape or a flow to the lava. So I'm just kind of moving this kind of rod or blade almost in a wavy effect. And that's just to kind of create some direction to where the lava would be flowing. And then I can use that then also to help me when I'm kind of, I suppose, texturizing the top of this. So you can see I'm rolling the rod and moving it backwards and forwards, melting the surface of the styrofoam. And that's now creating this kind of bubbly texture. And I think that's ideal for this molten lava. It works really well. So you can see it's melting the styrofoam, picking it up and transferring it. And you've got these kind of strands of kind of melted styrofoam appearing where you're rolling the rod. So it works really well. So you just kind of blend in any of those kind of bits that you pick back up. And if you've looked at molten lava, and it is worth Googling it to get an idea of what it looks like, you'll see that. You'll see kind of has this kind of bubbly effect and kind of picks up bits of rocks and parts of it dries out or kind of cools down as it's going along. So, yeah, you really do want that kind of texture. So now I'm feeling a bit more confident with what I'm doing. I'm going to do the same effect, but on my main base. So I'm just cutting where the rocks will be, because obviously I want the rocks to appear a little bit higher than the lava itself. I said you could do this with a knife, and you could use a file to essentially push down where the molten lava would be, and you could use a glue gun on top of that. I haven't tested that, if I'm being honest, so I'm not sure how well that would work, but I have seen it on other YouTube videos. Although glue gun is usually used on cardboard rather than styrofoam, so I'm not sure how well the hot glue would work on top of the styrofoam. It might work in a similar effect to what I'm showing here. But I think this works really well, and you can see you've kind of created these direction lines, and that's really important. You want to move or create lines where the flow of the lava would be. So now I'm moving to my steel wire brush, and I'm just moving it in a circular motion over the kind of rocky areas, just to kind of create a bit of a texture and rough it up a little bit. To kind of create that kind of rocky texture. And then also with that brush, it's worth really pressing in, digging in with the brush, and you'll kind of create these little kind of dots and marks. So now I'm moving back to my knife, and I'm just chipping away at the edge of the rocks, because I don't want it to be a smooth curve. I want it to look like rock. And so I'm doing the same to the edges of the base as well, just chipping away different angles. And also kind of scraping away at the top as well. So again, I don't want a smooth surface. I want it to be very rough. There we go. So once you've done that, again, you can go back with your wire brush and just texturize that even more. So I'm now using the end of a small brush, a small paintbrush, just to add these holes and dots. What you don't want to do with that is just add lots of dots all over the place. Kind of be a bit more thoughtful about where you're placing them. Place them quite close to one another. And again, this will give you this kind of texture of a volcanic rock. It is worth, again, looking up volcanic rocks on Google, and you'll see what I mean. They have lots of these kind of little holes in them. So here I'm just taking another scrap piece of styrofoam and I'm just cutting off a little block so that I can make myself a smaller rock to go with the larger rock that you can already see on the video there. And just use the knife just to carve away at the styrofoam, almost like peeling an apple. And you just want to really curve the edges. You don't want there to be any kind of sharp edges or straight edges to this rock. So I'm just checking it fits in place. And then again, I'm moving back to my figure to get an idea of how well the foot will stand on this as a platform. And because it was quite curved, the foot wasn't kind of sitting very well. So I've taken a little bit more off the top. So there's a flatter platform really for the foot to rest on. And then I'm using the same method I've used for the main base, using that wire brush just to texturize the top and then using the end of this small paintbrush to add in these little holes. And you want the holes to be different sizes. You don't want them all the same size. Have them coming from different angles. And all of that will add to the realism of the piece. So here's my base before I've added any paint. So it's just deciding if the figure stands on it as you want it to. Do you need to add anything else? So I've decided to make another smaller rock. And here I'm just using a small file just to take away some of the parts of the styrofoam that were sticking up a little bit too much from where I used the electric foam cutter. So I'm just filing that down a little bit. And I'm also creating, if you like, an impression of where the lava would seep over the edges of the base. So now I'm just taking just a regular black acrylic and adding a primer all over. A good tip here for your smaller pieces is to use your small paintbrush and just to kind of push it into the bottom of the rock, and that will help you to hold up the styrofoam so you can paint it. You can also see here that I've added some white to the wet black acrylic where the lava would be, because I want the lava to be quite bright. I want it to be a strong yellow, orange and red colour. We need to lighten that. Yellow does not paint over black very well. So I'm just using white over the top of the black. You can see that's created a grey. And now I'm adding more white in the middle of the lava because I want to give it that kind of glow effect. So this is using a dry brush technique. You've seen me use that before. And to do that, you just mix yourselves a grey just with a bit of black and white. Make sure you load up the brush, so back and front of the brush, and then rub it off onto a bit of kitchen towel or a rag. So most of the paint is off the brush. And then you're just going to angle the brush so it's kind of flat against the surface, and you're just pulling that gently along the top of the texture or the base. And then as you pull it along, that will take off most of the wet paint. And then you can go a little bit more, a little bit harder or a bit firmer with the brush, backwards and forwards, quite rigorous with that brush to kind of then, again, pick up all of those textures on the top. So there you've just seen I'm using yellow, red to create the colours of the molten lava. Start with just a regular yellow acrylic. And once you've coated that, then take a little bit of white and you just want to lighten up the middle of where the lava would be. And again, this is all about creating this kind of glow effect, because this is hot molten lava and it glows. You want to create a blend with the colours to give you that impression that this is glowing. So I'm just using now a small brush to get into those little kind of valleys, if you like, where the lava is kind of seeping between the rocks, and just use a small brush to do that. and then take some of the red. Now I'm using quite an orange red here, so this is a cadmium red. And then I'm just pushing that into the edges, so where the molten lava meets the rocks, I'm just dabbing that in, and then I'm brushing it along. And what should happen is it should pick up the yellow paint that you've already put down. If you find that the yellow paint is already dry, then put some fresh yellow paint over the top first, and then add your red on the sides. And just keep moving the brush backwards and forwards, and that will create this kind of blend effect. So rather than it being like a red line on the end, you've got this blend between the red, the orange, and then the yellow in the middle. So once you've done that around all of the edges, you might need to then take a smaller brush again, just to get into those smaller areas. And the same technique, just a little bit of red and blend it into the edges, leaving a little bit of yellow in between. So again, you're creating this kind of glow effect. So I've also got more of a kind of a scarlet or magenta red on my palette here. And I'm going to use that again on the very edges. So I've used this kind of orangey red to kind of create this blend, but then I'm using the darker red right on the very edge. And again, this is all about creating this kind of glowing effect. So I'm also taking some of that red and I'm pushing it into some of the holes that I made earlier with the paintbrush. And this is just, again, to give the impression that lava has kind of seeped into some of these holes, is kind of bubbling up and it's splashing, or it's kind of moving underneath the rocks themselves. And I just think it kind of adds a neat effect, really. Now, if you look at, you could stop there, and I think it looks quite good, even without adding the purple and black, which is what I'm adding now. So I'm just using a bit of purple and a bit of black to, I suppose, add a bit more realism. Again, if you look at photographs of molten lava, you'll see there's kind of purple areas and there's little bits of black. So I'm just using the black on some of the parts that are kind of sticking up. So some of the raised areas of the molten lava, I'm just picking out with that purple and that black. And that just kind of creates more of a realistic effect. But you might not want to use that. And it's really up to you. It's your base. It's your design. So it doesn't have to look exactly like this one here. And then finally, I'm taking the very fine brush again with a bit of black. And I'm just darkening some of the holes. So when I was adding the dry brush effect, sometimes the bristles of the brush go inside the holes and it lightens them. So I've just added or made those darker with a brush. And here we go. This is the finished piece. So once all the rocks are in place, I haven't glued the rocks because I quite like the idea that you can move them around depending on which character you're using. So it is Airazor. So you can see I've moved the rocks so she can kind of stand upon them at the back there. It's just nice to have that flexibility. And of course, then you can remove the rocks altogether or put them on the edges of the base. And so here's Studio 86 Grimlock. There, breathing his fire blast, if you like, from his mouth. And I think he looks really cool too on top of this. So thank you for watching. Hope you enjoy. Hope you have a go. And don't forget to like and subscribe.